Hey guys, this is Rishi K and welcome to the Indian Unlocks. Today we're going to review the Magnus mic that we checked a few days back that was sent to us by Asus India for review. And yes, this is going to be a very interesting review. So without any further ado, let's roll the intro and let's get started. Off the bat, let's begin since this is going to take a while. Now the specs. There are 3 14mm studio grade condenser capsules inside this microphone, 3 pickup patterns, that is unidirectional, bidirectional, omnidirectional, with the frequency response up to 20 to 20,000 Hz that is specified by Asus as well, and the sensitivity of minus 35 plus or minus 3 decibels. There is Aura RGB lighting, USB 2.0 hub port, one auxiliary in, one headphone out for direct monitoring, a 1.5mm braided cable, and a hard shell carrying case. Now the package contents are a lot, and for this I would recommend you check out our unboxing video, here is a card for that. Amongst the few that are mentionable, a compact carrying case and other accessories, it's almost a complete package. Although I would have wished they included a small stand, to be honest. The design is a love it or hate it affair. I'm sure that everyone in the audience is asking, why did they put the logo on the back sides? What's the use? Well, if I had to take a guess, I think it is for the streamers and gamers that the logo would light up and the audience would be able to see instead of you. Call it branding or wear it proudly, whatever you feel like. And there is a separate very bright LED at the bottom so that you can be rest assured that the mic is in fact on. Build wise, it seems that the microphone has a metal build. It is almost completely made out of plastic, but it's quite rather strongly built and you should not have any issues as far as you don't drop it or something. For such scenarios, Asus does provide a hard carrying case. Now there is a Kensington lock on the mic itself just to be extra careful at the LAN events so that it does not get stolen. On the back side, that is the side that faces you, there are a lot of controls and IO ports. A headphone volume adjuster, a mic sensitivity dial, one headphone monitoring jack, one aux in jack, a mic pattern selector, that is a switch, a mic mute button followed by one LED on off button below it. And finally a USB in and USB hub port on either sides. Coming to the cable, it is quite strong and thick, although that can be a little issue to train the cable to bend a certain way in some tight spots as well. The length of the cable is quite adequate, about 1.5 meter. But if you wish to have a longer cable, you can do it since it is quite easily available and it's a standard USB 3.0 male to male connector, which is frankly available everywhere. By the way, let me tell you one thing, the USB hub will only work if the input of the mic is connected to a USB 3.0 port on the PC. Anyways, let's come to the mounting options. The mic has rubberized feet on the bottom that will help it stay in place. Although there is a standard tripod mount as well and an included accessory which you can use to mount it to a boom pole or a mic arm quite easily. As I said before, a small tripod could have been wonderful. Now let's look at the technology that the mic offers. There are three mics inside the black mesh that is on the top, and also what other reviewers might not have noticed, there is one more secondary mic that is just for noise cancellation. It is located on the front side that you don't really look at. But it's quite hard to find and you have to really look for it. Here it is on the picture. One gripe that I have with it is the mic mute button is not quite adequately located and it's not in the best place possible. Also, the light is not quite strong to begin with. This is not a major problem as such, but it is on the side and it's not possible to keep a subconscious track on it while streaming game or talking to the internet. Sound tests and my experience with the mic. So what is a mic review if you don't have a sound test in it, right? We did a sound test in the unboxing video as well. If you want to, you can check that. But now let's have another one. So here is a sound test through the different modes of the mic. Firstly, the cardioid mode. Hey guys, I'm Rishi K and this is the audio test for the Strix Magnus mic. So this I'm recording right now with the mono setting, and also I'm recording concurrently with the Focusrite studio setup that I have with me. So yeah, you're listening to me right now via the mono settings. So let's switch it to the stereo settings. All right. Secondly, let's come to the stereo mode. So now this is the stereo mode of the Magnus mic, and I'm also comparing it with the Focusrite as I told before. But the thing is that the Focusrite only records in mono. So yeah, you'll have to bear with that, but I'll do the stereo conversion in the post-production. So yeah, this is the audio test, testing 1, 2, 3, testing 1, 2, 3. And yeah, let's now switch it to electronic noise cancellation and let's have the keyboard test. And finally, Let's see the ENC mode itself. So now we are in the electronic noise cancellation or environmental noise cancellation mode of the Magnus mic. As I told before, I'm also concurrently recording with the Focusrite mic system. Both the levels while recording are equivalent, which means both the mics are recording at similar intensity, and I'm monitoring them in Audacity software as well. There will be no post-production in this, and this will be uploaded to SoundCloud as well, so you can check it in the description below. I'm currently sitting about 1 feet from the mic, or about 0.75 feet from the mic itself, and the audio is quite clear, as I would say. Let us now check the keyboard test and see if it indeed cancels out the keyboard noise as Asus expects it to be. Now, as Asus says, the ENC mode cancels the keyboard sound from the front of the mic. Let's see how well it performs. So yeah, we are now in the stereo mode, as you can see. Yeah, exactly. And I have the Corsair K65 RGB mechanical keyboard, although it does not make a lot of noise, but yeah, it does make a little bit of noise, which is irritating to some folks. So let's just type and see. Now let's test the ENC mode. ENC mode is on. Let's have the keyboard test. Well, that's quite an improvement, I would say. Although not everything is good with the ENC mode, in my opinion, the ENC mode will rip out the soul out of the speaker's voice. It makes the sound a little robotic. But wait, that's not all. If you think that I am being too brutal, wait till you see this. Hey guys, this is Rishi K, and right now we're going to demonstrate what we were talking a few minutes back, is that the headphone output lags a little bit behind in the ENC mode of this Magnus mic. And that is confusing a hell lot to many users, I think. And during, especially as Asus Stout said that this mic should be used in the ENC mode during LAN parties and all, I would not recommend them to use this with the audio feedback that the mic gives through the headphone jack. I think you should mute that instead of having the audio feedback through it. And what I want to prove with this video is that the mic is taking a little bit of processing time, and that is causing the latency to develop in this mic. So yeah, what we're going to do is just connect the auxiliary cable from the mic's output to this camera's input, that is the mic section. So let's just do that, and I'll show that the ENC mode is lagging behind and it is causing terrible nauseating feeling because of that. So let's just see that. So we are plugging the mic in, and now we are going to plug this into the camera's mic system. So let's see that. So yes, now whatever that you're hearing is through the camera's internal mics. So now I think so it is going too loud. Let me just reduce it a little bit. So hey guys, yeah. So now it is perfect. So let me just demonstrate. Now right now it is on stereo mode. As you can see, it's not yet put into the ENC mode. So yeah. Now let us try the ENC mode. So I'm switching to ENC mode, and now let's tap it. Right. Hey guys, this is Rishi K, and this is the test for the microphone for Magnus Strix series. So did you see the lag? Did you feel the lag? And yeah, this is the problem with this mic. Asus says that this mic is for gaming events and LAN events, but at LAN events we do use headphones, and if we plug the headphones into this using the ENC mode especially, the user might be a little bit more confused than normal. So yeah, I do not recommend to use this mode, and also monitor the output through the headphones as well. Just plug in your headphones into the PC that you're using and you should be fine. Do not plug it into this, or use the stereo mode, but that will defeat the purpose of the ENC mode. So that is the short analysis. Let's get back to the video itself. So you see, not only the ENC mode is a little soul crushing, for the lack of a better word, but it also can make you super confused if you are monitoring yourself through the mic's headphone jack due to the offset in the latency. Most probably the mic needs to process the audio to remove the noise, and thus introduces a small delay in the feedback. No other media will report this, I'm sure of this. But I have personally tested two Magnus mics so that I can be double confirmed that this is indeed a problem. I certainly would not recommend you to monitor the audio while in the ANC mode. The other mode's latency is not an issue as such. But in all fairness, the ANC mode will definitely help you out at the LAN parties and other crowded locations to get the best possible audio experience recording out of the Magnus. Also, the other modes like cardioid and the stereo mode are great for product voiceovers and interviewing some guests. With its compact size and lightweight nature, it will prove to be a must-have accessories at LAN parties, provided that you don't have to use the monitoring feature on the ENC mode. Please don't do that. Final conclusion, should you buy this mic today? For $150, translating to about 10 grand in Indian currency. Well, with the competition like the Yeti now available roughly at the same or even lower prices, do check the links below in the description for both the products. The Magnus, in my opinion, proves to be a great product. But let me just justify the statement. Because if you compare it to the Yeti mic, the Yeti would be a better product for voiceovers since it has a larger diaphragm than this one. But where the Magnus would excel? Yes, it is the ANC mode. I don't think so. ANC mode feature is trumped by any other microphones out there in this budget. When compared to the 20k audio system that I have from Focusrite, I feel that this is a good portable version. Although not quite quality as Focusrite, but it surely comes close enough to the task that it has to do for the price that it comes at. Also, this mic is great for streamers and LAN gamers, especially in crowded areas or LAN tournaments. The major disadvantage of this mic, according to me, is also its ANC mode, as we discussed earlier. But if you are fine with the audio samples that we did, and yes, the keyboard noise isolation also taking into consideration, you can surely buy this. So that's it for today. Hope you enjoyed the detailed review. If you like our efforts, do send in some love by liking the video. And if you wanna see more such videos, do subscribe to our channel. But only if you like to, no pressure at all. Also do check out our new series, Fun with Ryzen. We are really going to have some fun with it. Until next time, this is Rishi K for the Indian Unlocked. I hope you learned something today. Bye bye.